Hey there, BHS, and welcome back to the fifth episode of the Paw Print Newscast.
It's great to see you again, and we hope you enjoyed your two-day week.
Yes, and as we all know, it's time for Thanksgiving break. To get us in spirit, let's go see what Thanksgiving's all about. Honey, this turkey is delightful.
Thank you, sweetie. It's my grandpa's recipe.
Ooh, I want to know it.
You can't know it. Only the men in the family can know that.
Yeah, Kaylee, know your place.
Hush, Andrew. Kaylee, can you pass me the corn?
Mom, why do we eat corn on Thanksgiving?
Well, it all started with Squanto.
Squanto? Who's that?
The story begins in 1621 when Squanto decided to help the needy and suffering pilgrims how to survive the winter. Squanto showed the pilgrims how to plant and care for corn and squash in the Massachusetts soil. To demonstrate their gratitude, the pilgrims invited Squanto and the other Indians to a dinner celebration. This is the first Thanksgiving.
Wow, that was a great story. I never knew that.
Yeah, thanks, Mom.
Yeah, anytime. Not gonna have a corn?
Yeah.
Wow, I'm so informed now about the Thanksgiving feast and how it all started.
Same here, so historic.
Well, now that we know, let's go see what our students think about Thanksgiving.
Ready or not, here we come.
Senior Hannah Duncan, what is your favorite Thanksgiving food?
Definitely pumpkin pie, but you have to have whipped cream with it because without the whipped cream, it's just not the same.
So, Tanner, do you have any Thanksgiving traditions?
I just sit at home and play video games with some friends.
Nice.
I'm here with sophomore Ava Campbell. Ava, do you have a favorite Thanksgiving food?
Probably green beans. Green casserole.
Green beans. Nice. I'm here with Charlie Burt. Do you have a favorite Thanksgiving food?
Yes.
Meatball. I'm here with sophomore Yazzie Meeks. Yazzie, do you have a Thanksgiving tradition?
We usually just go to my aunt's house and just have food there.
I'm here with Boston Cheney. Are you going Black Friday shopping this year?
I'm planning to go with my dad to Walmart a little bit to see what there's around.
What are you trying to get this year?
Hopefully, I can get my dad a PlayStation 5. Aww. In a way, because he really wants one, but probably not.
I'm trying to get one of those Xboxes. I'm here with Senior Jacob Garver. Tell me, Jacob, what is your favorite Thanksgiving food?
Definitely stuffing.
Delicioso!
I liked pumpkin pie.
Tis the season. You know what that means? It's basically Christmas.
No. Slow your roll. We'll worry about the Christmas tree later. Today it's all about the poultry.
Yeah, you're right. But it is basketball season. I wonder what our teams look like.
Let's go see what our girls' team looks like.
Hi guys.
what are your predictions for practice today?
Oh, we're gonna do freaking 2-minute layups the whole practice.
Yep, I found them all right. Senior Abigail Dakin getting ready for practice. She made it, guys.
Thank you.
Deja and Esther from the girls' basketball team. So today, guys, what would you rate today's practice, 1 out of 10?
A 9.
Esther?
Probably like an 8. It was a really hard, good practice.
I would agree. I sat on the sidelines. It was pretty fun. How do you guys expect this season to go?
I think it'll go really well, actually, because we got, just like last year, we got people that are going to compete and do all the little things, and I just think we're going to have a really good season.
Yeah, like she said, we're going to be really good, but we have our full varsity team returning, so we've had a lot of time to play together.
Yeah, and we still got little things to work out, but we'll get there.
Yep. Okay. Okay, last question. What game are you guys most looking forward to?
OG.
Yeah.
Ooh, I don't know, guys. I kind of want to play St. Mary's.
I mean, yeah, both I still want payback from St. Mary's, so.
Both of them.
Yeah, both of them. Yeah, and we're going to crush them.
Yeah. Okay, thanks, guys. After practice, how did you think it went?
See, I think it went very well, actually. I mean, we had a little bumps in the road, not boxing
good
out or
rebounding
whatever.
Practice. You guys practiced it? I think it was really good.
Please come support us this season. And as always,
go Hawkins!
Hey, raise your hand if you didn't play live.
No, we're not going now.
Oh.
Just so you can think about it.
Okay, so, yeah, that's what I thought.
Oh. Okay, so we play Friday, right?
Yeah.
We won, right?
Yes.
Okay. We're going to make Chandler edit this a bunch. Okay. tell me your thoughts on this practice.
They're progressing.
Not after practice.
My weave like this, and I tripped and fell and scraped my left, I mean right knee.
And I hurt my right knee. I'm sweaty.
It wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be. We didn't die. We played good.
Hey, raise
your... Is that good?
Yeah.
To get ice?
Oh my gosh, I have a great idea.
Oh my word, Lexi.
So we should, you know what, stop the idea.
That the way you hold me. Feel so holy. Oh God, running to the altar like a track star. Can't wait another second. There's a way you hold me. Feel so.
Well, our team sure does look good. I hope we get to watch some of their games this season.
Let's go see if we have any other sports news.
Sports
is where
you currently are.
The football all-league teams were announced. On the defensive end, Lucas Pritchard received first-team all-defensive end. Brennan Coleman received second-team linebacker, and R.J. Cortez and Trey Johnson both had honorable mentions.
On the offensive side, Kenyon Poling received second-team guard. Lex Bodecker received second-team tight end, and Wyatt Maley and Carter Parlapiano received honorable mention.
Even better than that, the all-district teams were announced. On the defensive end, Lucas also received first-team all-defensive end, and Brennan Coleman received second-team all-district linebacker.
For offense, Canyon Poling received second-team all-district offensive guard. For girls soccer, all-NWO district, Chandler Clark received district player of the year, Coach Haymans received assistant coach of the year, Chandler Clark and McKenna Hale received first-team all-district, Rachel Clark received second-team all-district, and Abby Dakin received honorable mention.
So congratulations to all those athletes. Hopefully we can keep it up during the winter season. The girls basketball team played Lima Senior on Friday night and played Marion Local tonight at 7. If you want to go support them, make sure you go see Mr. Staley to get some tickets.
The boys team plays this Friday in the annual tip-off classic, but due to COVID restrictions, the game will be held at LCC where they take on the T-Birds.
So good luck to all our teams this weekend. That's all we got for sports.
The Country Club Hills neighborhood is a friendly, pleasant residential community nestled between the hills of the Lost Creek, Metzger, and Ferguson Lake reservoirs on the east side of Lima, Ohio.
I like living in Country Club Hills because I like living near my friends.
There are over 500 households in our 244-acre neighborhood. There is a shelter house with picnic tables and grills and a swing set. Country Club Hills is a part of the Bath Township Schools.
I like living in Country Club Hills because I have nice neighbors.
Our neighborhood is located near the Eastgate Shopping Plaza and has easy access to Interstate I-75. There are numerous stores and restaurants located along Harding Highway.
I like living in Country Club Hills because I'm close to all my friends and the restaurants.
We have an excellent relationship with Bath Township trustees to improve our roads and services to our community. So, come join us and be an important part of your community.
Hamburg pickle on top makes your heart go flippity flop.
Have you had your keepy today? What we've always done. Long live all the small towners, sun up the sun banners, that old school
haggard and hang. Long live long neck bottles and I wonder what this weekend's weather holds for us.
Yeah, I hope it's raining pie.
Pie? Well, all pies on Gracie and Lexi as they tell us what the weather is for this weekend.
Thanks, guys. Now for some Thanksgiving weekend weather.
On Wednesday, it is a high of 50 with a low of 35, and it's going to be mostly sunny.
On Turkey Day, it's going to be a high of 56 and a low of 43, and it's going to be partly cloudy.
On Black Friday, it is a high of 53 and a low of 36, and it's going to be rainy.
And on Saturday, it's going to be a high of 46 and a low of 34 and partly cloudy.
And to recover from the long weekend on Sunday, it is a high of 48 and a low of 35, and again, partly cloudy. You ain't going home with me. Girl, nobody, nobody, nobody gonna love you like I do. Yeah, nobody, nobody, nobody gonna love you like I do.
If you think this Thanksgiving episode is almost over, you ain't seen stuffing yet.
Definitely, because we saved the best for last. Blaze.
I wonder what he's thinking about today.
Blaze. My family told me if I keep telling Thanksgiving jokes, I'm not invited to dinner anymore. I told them I can't quit cold turkey, so if anyone wants to invite me to their Thanksgiving dinner, I'm free.
Hey Kenna, what's the best type of music to play during Thanksgiving dinner?
I don't know, what is it?
Plymouth Rock.
That was a good one. Well, thanks for joining us this week.
We hope you have a great 5-day weekend.
Spend some good time with your family, eat some good food, and as always, be safe.
See you next time and happy Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving's all about.
What?
What? So I thought. I'm gonna laugh in a little bit. I shouldn't have had coffee this morning. Iconic. Same here. So iconic. So iconic.
You can change it. When I was writing it, I was like, what do I say about this? Oh. Don't say that.
So
dope.
Delightful. So
dope.
So historic. So historic.
Yeah, no one
told us who's talking.
Are
you ready?
Ready or not, here we come.
I did not want to say anything.
Ready or not, here we come. I'm trying to say it in a way that's not like weird.
I don't want to say any of this.
Hey, are you dissing on my opening?
I don't think I've ever said slow your roll in my life.
You ain't seen stuffing yet.
Triumphant. That's the word.
Do you think this Thanksgiving episode is almost over? You ain't seen stuffing yet.
Really? Really, Lainey?
Oh, that's a good pun.
Guess you gotta do it one more time. Last for last. Blaze.
Oh man. Hey Kenna.
Hey what?
I should probably go to bed so I don't undo the God over you that it took so long to find. Cause all it would take is seeing your face and not forget. I should probably go to bed. I should probably turn off my phone. I should quit while I'm out.
should probably leave you alone. Cause I know in the morning I'll be calling, saying sorry for the things I said. So I should.